Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats as our program is beginning. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats as our program is beginning. Ladies and gentlemen, please join us in welcoming President and CEO, Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce, Gigi Godwin.
Good evening, everyone. Are you happy? Woo! Good evening, everyone. I'm Gigi Godwin. I'm President and CEO of the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce. And on behalf of the Board of Directors and all our members, it is a great honor to welcome all of you here tonight for the Chamber's 55th annual dinner. 55th annual dinner, people. Pretty amazing. Tonight, we celebrate with confidence. What's next is here. With great private and public assets within our community, poised and ready to grow and win. Tonight, the Chamber will honor four recipients with special awards. The Chairman's Award, presented to an outstanding member of the Board of Directors. For our Public Sector Partner of the Year, a federal government agency. Our very first MCCC Business Advocate of the Year. And an elected official recognized as Legislator of the Year. Through their commitment to the community, their leadership, and great work in business and in the government, We will demonstrate again tonight that what's next is right here. Also tonight, we will watch as the newly elected Board of Directors and officers take their annual oath of office. And we'll experience what is now famous, the incredible passing of the torch from outgoing Chair Chris Carpenito of HESS Construction. To our incoming chair, Lisa Cines of Dixon Hughes Goodman. Yes, so you'll have to wait for it, the end of the program. We encourage you to tweet about tonight's event using our Twitter handle. Who knows how to tweet here? Oh, I see a couple hands going up. Okay. At MCCCMD and hashtag MCCC Annual Dinner, which is on the front of your program book. So tweet away. And now, we invite all veterans of the United States Armed Forces to stand and remain standing to be recognized. All veterans in the room, please stand so we can thank you for your service. And now would everyone please stand for the singing of the national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. For the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rang glad, the bombs bursting in air gave proof to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And now, please join me in saying thank you to our sponsors who have made this evening possible. First, please join me in thanking our award sponsors. Public Sector Partner of the Year Award sponsors, Madison Services Group, Palermo Mazda PLLC, and Spectrum Healthcare Resources. MCCC Business Advocate of the Year Award sponsor, RMR and Associates. Legislator of the Year Award sponsor, Lockheed Martin Corporation. We thank our platinum sponsors, Adventist Healthcare, AstraZeneca MedImmune, Dixon Hughes Goodman LLP, HESS Construction, Hughes and EchoStar Company, Kaiser Foundation Health Plan of the Mid-Atlantic States, Inc., M&T Bank, Marriott International, I hear the Marriott Group, Motorola Solutions, Inc., Redcoats, Inc., Admiral Security, and Data Watch Systems, Inc., Shapiro and Duncan, Inc., Sodexo, Inc., and SunTrust Bank. Thank you all for your generous sponsorships. And we thank our Board of Directors reception sponsor, Shapiro and Duncan. And we thank our general reception sponsor, Watkins Meegan. Thank you. And now we thank our gold sponsors. Thank you for sponsoring this event and for all of our advocacy and our member programs throughout the year. Gold sponsors, we couldn't do it without you. And we thank our silver sponsors, who are also listed on the screen. Thank you for your support of this wonderful evening of celebration. And we also say thank you to Comcast for producing a Newsmakers red carpet video of this annual dinner, which you'll be able to see on our website and on television. So thank you, Comcast. Thank you to all our sponsors who make this evening possible, as well as all of the events that we do throughout the year. Now, I didn't do that because I was hearing the sound of commerce and I was totally cool with that. So just putting that out there. Anywho, we'd like to give special thanks to the annual dinner committee for their incredible dedication and hard work in selecting the awards for tonight. And I'm gonna actually call the annual dinner committee members by name. Annual Dinner Committee Chair and General Counsel of the Chamber, Pamela Mazza of Palermo Mazza. Outgoing Chairman of the Board, Chris Carpenito of HESS Construction. Chair-elect Lisa Cines of Dixon Hughes Goodman LLP. Gus Bauman of Beverage and Diamond. Thank you. John Cannon of SunTrust Bank, thank you. Dr. Stuart Edelstein of the Universities at Shady Grove. Terrence Kenny of TD Bank. And Kwasi Rogers of Federal National Commercial Credit. Thank you to the committee who made all the tough decisions for getting us organized tonight. Thank you for your service. And now we'd like to recognize some of the special guests who are here with us tonight. From the federal government, please join me in welcoming from the United States Department of the Army, Office of the Secretary of the United States Army, the Office of Small Business Programs, Director Tracy L. Pinson. And from the United States Senate, please join me in welcoming from the Office of Senator Barbara Mikulski, Lori Edberg. From the Office of Senator Ben Cardin, Ken Reichert. And please join me in welcoming from the United States House of Representatives, from the Office of Congressman Chris Van Hollen, District Director Joan Kleinman. From the Office of Congressman John Delaney, Kevin Mack. There you are, thank you. And now from the state of Maryland, on behalf of Attorney General Doug Gansler, State Delegate Jolene Ivey is with us tonight. Thank you for being with us. From the Maryland General Assembly, State Senators, Vice Chair of the Senate Delegation, Nancy King. And Senators Karen Montgomery, Brian Feldman, and a very special welcome and thank you to Jenny Forehand, who is retiring this year after 36 years of serving in the General Assembly. Thank you for your service. and thank you for joining us this evening. From the Montgomery County Delegation to the Maryland House of Delegates, Montgomery County Delegation Chair Ann Kaiser. Montgomery County Delegation Vice Chair Susan Lee. And State Delegates Eric Lubke, Craig Zucker, Kathleen Dumay, David Fraser Hidalgo, Aruna Miller, Ariana Kelly, Kumar Barve, Bonnie Cullison, Sam Aurora, Tom Hucker, and Charles Barkley. Thank you all for joining us tonight. From our Montgomery County government, please give a warm welcome to our own county executive, Ike Leggett. Let us also welcome from the Montgomery County, Maryland State's Attorney's Office, State's Attorney John McCarthy. And Montgomery County Sheriff Darren M. Popkin. And police, Park Police Chief Antonio Duvall. Thank you. Our public safety partners are here with us tonight. Please join me in welcoming members of the Montgomery County Council, President Craig Rice. And council members Roger Berliner, Nancy Florine, Mark Elrich, and Nancy Navarro. Thank you for joining us tonight. And at this time, we also welcome Montgomery County Department officials. We have Director of Economic Development, Steve Silverman, and we also have Department of General Services Director, David Dice. From the Montgomery County School Board, please welcome Superintendent Dr. Joshua Starr. School Board President Philip Kaufman, Vice President Patricia O'Neill, and Board Members Shirley Brandman, Rebecca Smondrowski, and Judy Daka. Thank you for joining us this evening. I also want to give a special shout out to my Chamber of Commerce colleagues, my colleagues who are fellow CEOs at other chambers who have joined us this evening. Please welcome Kathy Snyder, Maryland State Chamber. Kathy, where are you? Retiring off to the beach, but we're grateful for our partnership. Thank you. Marilyn Balcom, Gaithersburg Germantown Chamber. Janana Taliano, Bethesda Chevy Chase Chamber. Jane Redeker, Silver Spring Chamber. Janice Freeman, African American Chamber and member of our advisory board. And Holly Sears Sullivan, our good partner at the Montgomery County Business Development Corporation. Thank you, colleagues, for your service and for our partnership. Because this dinner marks the introduction of our new board members, we'd like to take a very special moment to just say thank you to important guests who've served as leaders, our past chairs who have joined us this evening, former chairs of the Chamber of Commerce. Please stand at your table to be recognized. Mr. Charles Atwell. Ms. Eileen Cahill. The Honorable Jean Cunahan. Mr. Sterling Crockett. Mr. Thomas J. McElroy. And Mr. Stephen A. Robbins. Thank you, all former chairs. In fact, thank you all for building the solid foundation that supports the success we enjoy today. As we celebrate our 55th annual dinner, we are grateful for their leadership and recognize some of the great initiatives launched by our former chairs of the chamber during their service. The Public Safety Awards, official recognition of acts of valor within 5 Montgomery County Public Safety agencies. PSA was in its 40th year. Congratulations to our leaders and Steve Robbins, who chairs that, starting with this chamber. Leadership Montgomery, organization celebrating its 25th year, started at the chamber. Congratulations, Leadership Montgomery. Montgomery County Business Roundtable for Education, started with the chamber. The Alliance for Workplace Excellence, started with the chamber. And now, in its 5th year, the National Veteran Institute for Procurement, which now boasts 350 veteran-owned business graduates from across the nation. Do we have any VIPs here, part of that group? Yay! Let's hear it for our VIPs. And let's hear it for every great idea has a beginning, and we thank 55 years of business leaders that came before any of us in this room tonight. We thank them for their vision. And now, if you will join me for someone special who will come to the podium, please join me in welcoming to the stage our chairman of the board, Mr. Chris Carpenito.
Thank you, Gigi. It's been my honor to serve as the chairman of the chamber. One highlight of my year of service was the chamber's celebration of the 40th Public Safety Awards luncheon, which took place on March 14th. A community that is safe is one that can succeed. As a special way to mark this anniversary year, Billy Peel of Red Coats commissioned a commemorative coin which was given to all guests at the ceremony. It is the extra efforts such as these that have made my time as chair so rewarding. So many of you here tonight have chipped in, stepped up, and added to the momentum of improving the business climate in Montgomery County and in Maryland. This year, our board established a business climate and tax structure group that helped shape our legislative agenda. This year, we continue to impact the marketplace with programming around health IT, green business, and global trade. This year, we built upon the success of the past 10 years to hold a government procurement conference that is unrivaled in the region and creates opportunities at the local, state, and federal levels for our small businesses. Each of you have given your best thinking, your time, and have shared this information with colleagues and clients. It is with all of you that I stand here today to celebrate our success and look forward in my new role as immediate past chair to working with the executive committee and our chair and chair-elect to continue the good work. Thank you to the board of directors for your support. And now, it is time to turn our attention to the official annual meeting and the installation of our new board of directors and new officers, one of my last official acts as chairman of the board. Before that, though, I would also like to take a moment to say thank you to Gigi and the wonderful staff we have at the chamber. Each member of the staff has worked tirelessly over the past year, as they do every year, to advance the mission of the chamber and address the needs of our members. Much of this work is done quietly without Gloria fanfare, and it is only appropriate that as the Chamber celebrates another year of success tonight, we take a moment to thank those who make it all happen. At this time, I would like to ask that Gigi and each member of the Chamber staff here tonight, please stand and wave from wherever you are in the ballroom so we can extend a proper thank you for your efforts. From the bottom of my heart, on behalf of the board and members of the Chamber of Commerce, thank you for another year of hard work, success, and dedication to the mission and its chamber and members. So as tonight's event serves as the Chamber's annual meeting of memberships, I'd like to take a moment to introduce our new officers for the upcoming year, all of whom are listed on the screen, I believe. Okay. Please refrain from applause until the end. Thank you. Officers, please stand when your names are called and remain standing, starting with our new chair of the board, Lisa Cines, CPA of Dixon Hughes Goodman. Chair-elect, Jerry Shapiro of Shapiro & Duncan. Immediate past chair, myself. General Counsel, Pam Mazza of Palermo Mazza. Treasurer, John Cannon of SunTrust Bank. Secretary, Terry Kenny of TD Bank. Vice Chair of our Audit Committee, James Martinko of Cohn Resnick LLP. Vice Chair of the Economic Development Committee, Leslie Ford Weber of Johns Hopkins University, Montgomery County Campus. Co-Chair, our Economic Committee Development Committee, Dr. Stuart Edelstein of the Universities of Shady Grove. Vice Chair, GovConNet Committee, Kwasi Rogers of Federal National Commercial Credit. Co-Chair, GovConNet Committee and GovConNet Council Representative, Alexandra Lexi Kessler of Aronson LLC. Vice Chair, Infrastructure and Land Use Committee, Gus Bauman of Beverage and Diamond. Co-Chair, Infrastructure and Land Use Committee, Peter Monge of MedStar Montgomery Medical Center. Vice Chair, Legislative Affairs Committee, Tom McElroy of Hughes and Echo Star Company. Co-Chair, Legislative Affairs Committee, Josh Bokey of Comcast. Vice Chair, Small Business Committee, Clark Kendall of Kendall Capital Management. Co-Chair, Small Business Committee, Neil R. Simons of Independent Benefit Services. And last but not least, Chamber President and CEO, Georgette Gigi Godwin. Please join me in a round of applause for the 2014-15 officers of the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce Board of Directors. Thank you. Okay. Now, if the officers will remain standing, I invite all members of the Board of Directors to please stand for the swearing-in ceremony. If all our board members would please stand. We have them all? Okay, there we go. Okay. Members of the board, would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name, do solemnly swear to faithfully execute my duties as a director of the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce, and to do all within my power to advance its mission for the betterment of Montgomery County, Maryland, and all of its citizens, and to always act in the best interests of the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce and its members. You are now officially members of the 2014-2015 Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce Board of Directors. Congratulations. Now, each year at the annual dinner, the chairman enjoys the great honor of recognizing the hard work and dedication of a fellow member of the Board of Directors with the Chairman's Award. Would board member Kenny King of the Ezra Company please join me on stage? Kenneth C. King serves on the Chamber's Board of Directors and is a Senior Vice President with the Ezra Company, a top tenant advisory firm in the Washington metropolitan area. Kenny skillfully renegotiated the expiring lease for the Chamber's offices at 51 Monroe Street. He used diligence, tenacity, analytical expertise, and market knowledge to bring one full year of negotiation to a successful conclusion. With a complete understanding of his clients' needs, Kenny's work guaranteed that the Chamber will enjoy the benefits of this successful negotiation for many years. Kenny also served as a guest speaker at the Chamber's Small Business Member Meeting. His presentation on the art of negotiation shared techniques and tips to achieve a win-win solution. Kenny, you are truly deserving of this honor. It has been my pleasure to serve with you. This year in my capacity as the chairman of the board of director of the members of the Chamber of Commerce.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Dan, why don't you say a few remarks and then we're going to take pictures.
Okay.
Yes.
Good evening. In an effort to keep this brief, before I get started, I'd like to thank Chris for selecting me as this year's recipient of the prestigious Chairman's Award. In addition, I would like to thank the Executive Board Committee, as well as the entire board, for supporting our efforts throughout the lease renewal process. It has been a pleasure to work with such a passionate group of individuals who generously give of their time to help the community prosper today, tomorrow, and for the county's continued success in the future. As in many cases, to have a successful outcome, there are a number of people who have been instrumental throughout the process. Some of the people I would like to acknowledge include my team members from the Ezra Company, Erica King and Colin Lennon, Greg Noop of OKKS Studio Architects, our project management team of Selva Ganache and Richard Kennington of KGO Project Management, and most of all, the entire MCCC personnel who made this an enjoyable and rewarding experience. To that extent, I would like to personally thank Gigi Godwin, Barbara Ash, and Joni Abendasa for all of their hard work in supporting our efforts. Further, I would like to thank Tom Ragnell and Phil Dickinson of RIT for their help throughout the transaction and for continuing to support the Chamber, not only as their landlord, but also as an active member of the Chamber, of the Chamber's Board of Directors. During my time on the board, I have met many interesting people who are there to serve the best interests of our community. I am truly inspired by my fellow board members and take great pride in helping MCCC reduce their annual facilities costs, enabling them to better utilize such funds towards their mission, initiatives, and programs. I look forward to my continued participation and support of the Chamber and would encourage all of you to take an active role in such a highly regarded organization. Thank you again for this honor, and please enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
earlier this evening, the chamber presented Chris with his chairman's gift, and in keeping with tradition, we also gave him an actual chairman's chair, something to look forward to for future chairs as well. So please join me in a final round of applause for Chris Carpenito, our outgoing chair, for his wonderful leadership this year. And now, dinner's served. Please enjoy. We'll be back in about 20 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our program resumes in 10 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. Our program begins in 2 minutes. Thank you. We will now continue the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce 55th Annual Dinner Program. To present the Public Sector Partner of the Year Award, please join us in welcoming Managing Partner of Pilera Maza, Pamela Maza, President of Madison Services Group, Ann Sullivan, and Senior Vice President of Operations of Spectrum Healthcare Resources, Mary Ann Coins.
Good evening. The Public Sector Partner of the Year Award recognizes an organization that works in partnership with the Chamber to propel its missions forward. Tracy Pinson became the Director of the Office of Small Business Programs, Secretary of the Army in May 1995. As Director, she advises the Secretary of the Army staff on all small business procurement issues, and is responsible for the implementation of the federal acquisition programs designed to assist small businesses. Pam, should we tell some Tracy Pinson stories right now?
I'm not sure.
As one of the top females in the Army's acquisition career field, she's responsible for the integration of small business strategies developed at Army headquarters. Ms. Pinson provides management and oversight for the Army's Mentor-Protege program, as well as historically black colleges and universities and minority institutions program. She develops policies and initiatives to enhance their participation in Army-funded programs.
And Tracy has worked with the Chamber for many years and serves on our Montgomery County Advisory Board and the GovContinent Procurement Conference Steering Committee. Her invaluable support of the conference as both a panelist and a strategic advisor helped to build a value speaker panels. She has ensured participation by the Army, the Navy, and the Air Force at our procurement conferences. She has long supported the Chamber Foundation's Veterans Institute for Procurement by appearing as a speaker and including during the federal government shutdown last October. So that doesn't leave this room. Director Tracy Pinson has demonstrated a sustained and lifelong commitment going above and beyond in the effort to help the most small businesses possible to succeed in federal government contracting. So with deep appreciation for her leadership, we are honored to present this award to Tracy Pinson. Please join me in welcoming Tracy to the stage.
Guys, this is my 1 minute of fame. Thank you so much. Okay, just for a little while, calm it down. I think a lot of deliberation went into giving these awards, and I am totally honored and privileged to getting one. So just for a minute, trust me, I know the value of networking, and I definitely would promote that. But let me just say thank you to the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce. I actually asked to be on the advisory board, and they were like, you need to be sponsored by someone. And so Pam was so gracious to sponsor me, and it's been a wonderful experience because I think they're critical in the development of small minority businesses, which is what I do on a regular basis. The Army has the number one small business program in the federal government. $17 billion going to small business, minority business, women, and we met the 5% goal for women, 5%. Service disabled veteran, $4 billion. Hoo-ah! Anyway, I'm not going to talk too long. This is a very important chamber, and I want to continue to support it. So, I have a major announcement to make. Okay, so the theme of this dinner is what's next. So what's next for Tracy is I'm retiring from the federal government on June 30th after 33 years of service. Hoo-ah! And my next career is going to be working for the Boeing Defense and Space Sector to run their small business program. So I'm going to do for Boeing what I did for the Army. So thank you so much for your support. Hua, I love you, and I will see you in the next chapter. Thank you so much.
To present the Business Advocate of the Year Award, please join us in welcoming President and CEO, RMR & Associates, Robin Sachs.
Good evening. How is everyone doing tonight? It truly is an honor and a privilege to be here tonight. I'd like to thank the entire chamber, the new board, congratulations for giving me this opportunity. I am a lifelong Marylander and a proud Terp. Yay, go Terps. And it's an honor to be here tonight to present this award to Clark Kendall. Just a little bit of background. Clark and I originally met a few years ago when Clark was looking to establish his brand image and to get greater awareness for his firm, Kendall Capital Management. Together, we branded Clark as the premier financial advisor for the Montgomery County middle-class millionaire. And I'm sure there are a lot of middle-class millionaires in the room tonight. Not only is Clark my client, but I am Clark's client, and I can tell you, Clark is the best. Not only do they deliver on the expectations that I had for a certified financial planner, but Clark has exceeded all of my expectations. Now on to the award. The Business Advocate of the Year Award recognizes the significant impact of advocacy efforts to advance the Chamber's goals. As an active member of many committees, Clark has attended and co-chaired many meetings throughout the year where advocacy was discussed. Then, as the Maryland General Assembly got underway, Clark pursued one of the chamber's priorities, which was tax reform. Now, how many here would like to pay less taxes? I think we all would, right? Okay. Well, the net result of Clark's work with the Maryland General Assembly is Maryland will now be recoupling. I don't know if you guys know, but they decoupled the estate tax from the federal. Clark has gotten the recoupling along with the chamber, which is going to save everyone in this room a lot of money. From $1 million to $5 million, Maryland estate tax will gradually be going up. Now, I think that's huge for all of us. It's going to save everyone a lot of money. So in conclusion, Clark is truly deserving of this award for being a strong advocate for small business and all Marylanders. It is my distinct honor to welcome the Business Advocate of the Year Award to my friend, President and Founder Clark Kendall.
Hey, I'm very humbled and honored to be recognized tonight. It's been a long road, and I appreciate everyone's work. I started Kendall Capital 10 years ago, but the joke in the office is, you know, my pretty face gets the business, but my two colleagues, Paula Bruning and Margie Logie, are the brains of the operation. I want to thank them. Also, RMR has done a great job. I am an advocate for that middle-class millionaire, and there are some needs. Montgomery County, Maryland needs middle-class millionaires. To run any type of business, too, you got to have the support of your wife. And my wife has been a big supporter of me for the past 27 years. She believed in me, and she keeps on pushing me and sort of say, you can do it. And she's always had that unfailing confidence. But I also want to do a shout out to our own Ilya Hopkins. She's the political advocate here at the Montgomery County Chamber. To say the least, in the state of Maryland, Annapolis is a political maze. And Ilya did a great job. She dressed me up. She put, as I like to say, she put lipstick on the pig. She pointed me in the right direction. And she let me voice my opinion. And quite frankly, they heard us in Annapolis. So I thank her very much. I don't know if many of you know this, but I always think of myself, I am Montgomery County. I've lived here since 1967, even though I don't look that old. I lived here, I went to public elementary, middle, and high school. But my first job was I worked for Sam Eig at the Washingtonian Country Club, bussing tables. For you who've only lived here 20 years or less, the Rio Grande is now where the Washingtonian used to sit. Working as a busboy at $1.60 an hour, it was the most valuable lesson I ever learned. I learned and watched a man who watched the revenue, who kept track of the costs, but he knew every single busboy, waitress, and dishwasher's name. He cared about people, and that really stuck with me. Later on in life, I had the opportunity to work for a man called Willard Derrick. Willard Derrick, whether you know it or not, was the engine that took Sandy Spring Bank from a one branch bank at $10 million to a $2 billion institution. And what Willard Derrick did, he always said, care about people first, and the money will come back to you tenfold. And that's so true. The last person that I've admired for a long time has actually been my own father. And many years ago, he was on this stage, and he was actually one of the original Beltway Bandits, as I like to call him. He's probably shaking his head over there at table 10 right now. But let me tell you something, many times at our dinner table, he'd win a government contract and come home and say, I won the contract, now I got to manage and motivate people to make money. His motto while I was growing up was bid to win, manage for profit. But what that really brings us down to is Montgomery County is really about people first. And that's what we do. We do business between people and people working together. But businesses and individuals need to make money. I can't emphasize that enough. As a private client wealth manager, before the recent changes in the Maryland estate tax law, I would sit down and strategize with clients, and we would strategize when and how those wealthy middle-class millionaires should leave Maryland. I'm proud to say that when clients now come into Kendall Capital, there's no longer the agenda item, when do we leave, or what's our exit strategy from the state of Maryland. And I applaud our officials for taking the first step to making Montgomery County and Maryland a better and friendlier place for that middle class millionaire. Tonight, I encourage every single person in this room to think about one law and regulation that our legislators could change to make Montgomery County a friendlier place for each individual. Because when you write laws and regulations to incentivize individuals to work in the best interest of the community, we all win. The decoupling of the Maryland, or the recoupling, I should say, of the Maryland inheritance tax for the benefit of the middle-class millionaire is a win for everyone in this room. And also, not only for everyone in this room, but for the Montgomery County and the state of Maryland. So thank you again for the generous recognition, and may God continue to bless Montgomery County.
To present the Legislator of the Year Award, please join us in welcoming Vice President, Lockheed Martin Corporation, Lawrence Duncan III.
Good evening. The Legislator of the Year Award recognizes a legislator who exemplifies the ideals of the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce, a passion for innovative ideas, a commitment to economic growth and prosperity, and a dedication to our community. I am pleased to say that this year's recipient is Maryland State Senator Nancy King. Senator King has consistently led the fight to strengthen the business community in Montgomery County and the state of Maryland. Senator King was first elected to public office in 1994 as the District 1 representative to the Montgomery County Board of Education. In 2003, she was elected to Maryland's House of Delegates representing District 39. 5 years later, she was appointed to fill the seat left vacant by the retirement of Senator P.J. Hogan. In 2010, she was elected in her own right to the Senate. And I am happy to say that she is running unopposed in 2014. Senator King has many important responsibilities in the Maryland legislature, including serving as the Assistant Deputy Majority Leader, serving on the Budget and Taxation Committee, including Capital Budget and Education, Business and Administration Subcommittees, Senate Chair of the Joint Committee on Children, Youth, and Families, and Senate Chair of the Joint Committee on Gaming Oversight. During the 2014 legislative session of the General Assembly, Senator King led the way on several important issues that were critical to the chamber's agenda. On the Budget and Taxation Committee, she supported funding for the Veterans Institute for Procurement, and she went the extra mile to refute the analysis submitted by the Department of Legislative Services. She sponsored a research and development tax credit for existing and new businesses. She was one of two Montgomery County senators who voted to support a recoupling of the Maryland estate tax with the federal rate. She worked with the delegation and county officials to advance school construction funding, and she served on the budget caucus in the final days of the session to produce a balanced budget for FY15 that includes several initiatives to make Maryland more competitive. Time and time again, Senator King has demonstrated her commitment to a strong business climate in Maryland in order to keep and grow jobs in our community. We are very appreciative of Senator King's willingness to listen and to do the hard work necessary to keep Maryland competitive. So it is my honor to present Senator Nancy King with the Legislator of the Year Award. Please join me in welcoming to the stage the Honorable Nancy King.
Thank you very much. I told the people at my table I had a 30-minute speech, and they were all ready to leave. It really is a pleasure to be chosen for this award tonight. I have worked with the chamber for a lot of years. Gigi Godwin is a person you can never say no to. But I have worked with the legislative committee, and the issues that are important to the chamber are issues that are important to everybody else in the county. As a former small business owner, I know how hard it is to turn a profit. I know how hard it is to keep those employees happy, and I know how hard it is to pay all those taxes. When we started talking about the estate tax this year, it was a lot of pushback from that. There is still a lot of misunderstanding in the county about what that is. If you listen to some of the more progressive groups, they feel that doing what we've done is taking from the poor and giving to the rich. That is something that needs to be explained to the public at every chance that we get. People don't understand that people that do make $1 million a year or have $1 million are paying a lot of taxes into the state of Maryland. So it's something that I encourage you to spread the word. If you've got a chance to explain that to somebody, please do it. I think if you look around the room tonight and you see how many legislators are here, you can see that the tide is changing in Annapolis. You know, we have a commission right now to look at the business climate in the state of Maryland. I think that's really important, and I'm really interested to see what comes out of that commission. I think there will be some good changes that will come out of it. Senator Feldman here, along with Kathleen Dumais, had bills in this year to look at our whole tax structure. Though they didn't pass, I can see it coming in the future. We have to look at all of it. That's one of the things that we hear from so many people is that we have too many taxes here in Maryland. So I think there will be some good things coming. The theme of tonight is what's next?
What's next is here,
and I think that we will be a part of what's next is here by encouraging more businesses to stay in Maryland and be as prosperous as they are. If you look around this room and the huge number of people that are here, you are what makes Montgomery County as successful as it is. So I congratulate you tonight for being here and for making our county as great as it is. I'd like to thank the chamber and thank Lockheed Martin, my sponsor for this evening. Can't do it without you. And it's just really been a joy to be here tonight. So thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to welcome to the podium the new chair of the Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce, Lisa Cines.
We're here tonight to celebrate the 55th anniversary of Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce. How ironic. I hate to publicly state that I have lived in this county for almost all of those 55 years. And this chamber reflects a bit of my journey. Tonight I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the history along with tonight's theme, What's Next Is Here. It is because of this deep connection that I am so honored to be standing before you this evening with friends, colleagues, family, and the leaders of the community. I am fortunate to embark on this role to work with some of the most talented people at the chamber. The staff, which you all know or don't know, led by Gigi, if you need any evidence of the talent that exists, just look at the event tonight. And this is one of many things that they do month in and month out. It's also an honor to be following the footsteps of my good friend, terrific community leader, Chris Carpenito. Under Chris's leadership, and with the guidance of the board's business climate and tax structure working group, which you just heard some references to, this chamber has had significant advocacy wins in Annapolis, including we heard about the improvement to the Maryland estate tax for business and owners and our families, which affects my client base significantly, so something that I was thrilled to see happen, increasing R&D, bio, and high-tech tax credits to support business growth, and supporting small business by expanding their access to state procurement opportunities. Under his leadership, this chamber strengthened strategic partnerships to offer key programs for our members, including our amazing GovNet procurement conference, which was just a few weeks ago, our agency on-sites, and our many matchmaking programs throughout the year. The vision that this chamber had to put in place access to what is such a precious resource in the region, being our government agencies. Forums that the chamber has led in health IT, global trade, and green business. Look for the buses in September with all of our green businesses on them. And if you want to get a bus, contact Barbara. The nationally recognized Center for Veteran Institute for Procurement, VIP as it's affectionately called, is an amazing another amazing program that the chamber puts on. So please join me in thanking our outgoing chair, Chris Carpenito of HESS Construction, with a round of applause. He's back there, but he can hear us, I think. Then the Chamber Board. I can't say enough about them, other than they're an amazing group of business advocates, which the Chamber staff is able to draw upon on a moment's notice. Just tonight, you've heard about Clark Kendall of Kendall Capital and his support of the advocacy of the Chamber. In addition, I've had the pleasure of working with Clark over the last year as co-chair of the Small Business Committee. You met Kenny King of Ezra Company, and you heard about his support. Hey, Kenny. You heard about his support of our lease renegotiation. Then there is the broader business, government, and legislative community that you all represent, who support the Chamber's work in so many different ways. Tonight you heard the great work of Tracy Pinson, Director of the U.S. Army's Office of Small Business Program. I've been working in government contracting for
many, many years, as many as Tracy, I think. And Tracy's a name that I have always heard throughout my career. What an amazing way to end her career with this recognition tonight. And then there's Maryland State Senator Nancy King. We've heard about the importance of having the advocacy in Annapolis and what an amazing supporter of business Nancy has been. So thank you for all your support. Thank you to all of our award winners for your ongoing support. But the theme of tonight's dinner, What's Next Is Here, has great meaning for me. As I said, Montgomery County has been my home. It's all I know. I grew up here, built my life's work here, raised my family. I live, work, and play here. And I'm a proud graduate, along with my husband, Larry, of Montgomery County Public Schools. My mother taught in Montgomery County Public Schools. Then my husband and I graduated from the University of Maryland. Our children followed us. Corey and Brittany graduated from the University of Maryland. Terps? Yay! My fellow Maryland alums and my fellow Chamber board members know that we're fortunate to live in such a great place. We have national assets, global geography, and incredible visionary leaders right here. And exciting visionary things happen here. After all, here is where visionaries map the human genome. I live like 2 miles from that, and help put a man on the moon. Looking to our future together, our business leaders and government partners are in aggressive pursuit of what's next here in Montgomery County. Cybersecurity, life sciences, pharmaceuticals, health IT, education, and the environment, the best practices in all professional services, and the new cutting-edge technologies will shape both the global human experience and our own community's quality of life. The great one, the hockey player Wayne Gretzky, often offers such a simple statement, but brilliant advice. Skate to where the puck is going to be, not where it has been. Well, I want everyone gathered here tonight to know that I am honored to serve on this chamber's board and to lead this chamber of the Board of Directors, because it is made up entirely of Wayne Gretzky's. But even the great one had coaches, and this chamber offers access to the best business coaches in the world. This chamber's Board of Directors and its management team is like no other. The chamber is focused on the future. Together we look ahead to determine where the puck is going, and we access the very best technical and professional service leaders for guidance. Your success is dependent on access to the best minds, best practices, and best information about where the future opportunities will be. We know that good information and the right partners and the best coaches help our businesses adapt early, win opportunities, and grow. Looking ahead shapes our advocacy priorities. We've heard a little bit about that tonight. To attract and retain businesses, to attract and retain top talent, and opportunity to Maryland. Looking ahead shapes our partnership with community organizations, education, and government to ensure a vibrant future for our community. Looking ahead shapes the types of programs we build to connect you directly to the information, decision makers, and opportunities that you need in order to win. And the only place we will succeed is to anticipate an ever-changing terrain of economic realities and then aggressively skate toward those opportunities. We know that good information and the right partners and the best coaches help our businesses adapt early, win opportunities, and grow. So look around the room. Who do you see? Are they on your team? We see great partners. We see talented colleagues. We see world-class coaches. Are there companies who are missing? Who can help us win? Who can help you win? Who can support our mission? And who should be part of shaping
our community's future success. Let's get them on the team, the Chamber's team. I need your help to advance our mission and to ensure the success of our community for the future, our home. Therefore, I ask you to join me in this call to action. Let us come together, partners, coaches, colleagues, and the world's top talent to answer the question, what's next, by shaping it here in Montgomery County. Together, we'll continue to build a vibrant, successful, happy future for our community, our children, the next generation. Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the passing of the chairman's torch.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like that's what you want to do. Here come bad news talking this and that.
Oh,